So you found the investment grade restaurant of your dreams and you want to buy it, but how do you finance that vehicle without getting ripped off? In this video, I'm going to show you how to do exactly that. Everyone. My name is Brooke Walsh and welcome to Restomod Academy. We focus on all things Restomod, which is one of my passions, and we try to simplify the ownership life cycle with a Restomod. How do you buy one, maintain it, and maybe eventually even sell it, all in one channel. And we accomplish that through tips and tricks, self-help videos, and product reviews. All heard the adage, probably from a grandfather or a grandmother, that you should not be paying cash for anything other than an investment. Well, I'm here to say that restomods are investments, and you can actually make money buying and selling restomods. So in this particular case, I think that qualifies for financing. In all seriousness, in this video, we're going to talk about ways to finance your restomod. So if you can pay cash, I guess the question is, should you? And if you can't pay cash, how do you finance it without getting ripped off? So before you go buy a restomod of your dream, I think you probably want to do a couple things. You probably want to understand what are your options that are even available to you, what are the pros and cons of each option. And then when you have that kind of information, you can make an informed decision. And that's what our goal is to help you make an informed decision around the purchasing or on the purchase of your investment grade restomod. So the first part is, let's talk about your credit. So this isn't a self-help channel to fix your finance and all that kind of your credit and all that kind of stuff. This is really a discussion of the better your credit, the better terms that you're going to get, and the more options that will be available to you. So if you've got really bad credit, I don't know that watching the rest of this video is going to really apply to you. That isn't really what we're trying to do here. We aren't trying to help you fix your credit or anything else. Rather, this video is for people who probably are working professionals, have good credit to great credit, and pay their bills on time and are able to afford a pretty substantial, investment grade vehicle, and might just not know about some options on how to pay for them. So let's talk about that. So there are a couple different types of loans, and again, most people probably are going to know this, but one type is a secured loan. So in a secured loan, you're using an asset to secure the loan. So in this particular case, this Restomod could be used as an asset with which you can borrow funds against. And again, the better credit you have and the better your bill payment history is, the more of a car loan you can probably qualify for. An unsecured loan would be exactly that. You're borrowing an unsecured amount of money based on, it could be a business that you have, and you have a certain track record, and so they're going to give you a line of credit in your business to go ahead and buy said Restomod. Or you might even qualify for an unsecured line of credit from your bank, which really a credit card would be a good example of an unsecured loan, more or less. And so let's talk about some options. So the first and foremost option I think everyone should consider would be if you own a home. So if you own a home, you may be able to qualify for a home equity line of credit. The home equity line of credit is typically just a way to borrow money against the equity you have in your home. So if your home is worth, 500 grand and you owe 200 grand, you've got $300,000 of equity, you might be able to borrow a portion of that and go buy your Restomod. The reason you would do that is, and the benefit is, obviously you can write off some of the interest, the mortgage interest that you're paying. So there's a little bit of a tax benefit there, and it's usually a pretty quick process. You can typically do a home equity loan in pretty quick order, and that's my best recommendation to do that. The other benefit is you get a 30-year AM, probably on that, or you've got some sort of a repayment schedule that's probably more favorable than an auto loan. The con of that is it's probably not that fast. Okay, so another option would be a personal loan from your bank for a car, just a typical car loan. So the pros of a car loan from your typical local banker are that they know you, they know your credit history, they know your background, and so those are good. You're not a complete stranger, in other words. Another advantage to your local banker is the speed. They can typically approve these loans in, an hour or two, depending on your credit. And so those are both great things. A couple disadvantages with a local loan would be, you know, they don't know how to evaluate the value of a restomod correctly, particularly an investment grade restomod. So that's a challenge. The other challenge could be your payment terms. Sometimes they will only finance a car for up to like 3 years or something like that. And so you might want a longer payment term, which in theory could reduce your payment. Those would be a couple of the cons of going with a local banker. Another option for classic car or restomod financing, I'm gonna combine them into one. Would be classic car dealership financing or working with some lenders that you might find through a classic car dealer. And then in this particular video, I'm going to tell you who they are so you don't have to go through a dealer. But in all seriousness, if you're buying a classic car or a restomod through a dealership, they can connect you to these classic car dealers. Woodside Credit would be a great one. JJ Bank and Company or another one, and Car Collector Lending would be a third one. And so those would be three different options that you can work with, and they specialize in classic car or restomod financing. The pros of using the specialized restomod lenders are a couple things. Number one, you don't have to buy from a dealer. These are good to be done through a private dealer or a dealership, and that's good. They understand this industry different than a bank, and so they will understand the value of your car different than a bank. What is the pro of these classic car lending? So the only pros I can come up with is, you know, they're not instant because they do need to get, depending on the price, I should say, of your vehicle, they do need to get an appraisal by an independent third party. So that does take a couple of days to get that done. And then their interest rates don't tend to be as low as you could probably get on your own. But in exchange for that, they give you longer payment terms. So generally speaking, these companies can go up to about 12 years, which is great if you want to have a lower payment. The only disadvantage is you're obviously paying more in interest. So there's pros and cons to everything, but their primary con, I think, would just be the amount of time it takes and probably to a certain extent their interest rate, because it's a little bit higher than you could get on a shorter term loan through your private bank. The other option, unsecured option, would be a credit card. Now that might sound crazy to some people, but depending on your credit score and the amount of credit you qualify for, you can get credit cards, $50,000 to $100,000 of credit on 1 year, no interest on some payment term. And then there's even some benefits around frequent flyer miles and things like that. So if you're gonna buy from a dealership, you might actually be able to put your classic car restomod purchase on a credit card, as crazy as that sounds. What are the pros of that? Well, the pros would be it's instant approval. It's pretty darn easy. Almost any dealership will accept it. The cons of using a credit card are probably pretty obvious, but number one, it's a credit card. So as long as you have, you know, 1 year interest, no interest or something like that, or low interest, eventually you got to pay that off, or else you're going to be paying probably around 12.5% interest, if not higher. So that's a problem. If you're buying from a private seller, it'd be unusual for them to accept a credit card. So that probably isn't even an option. But those would be probably the main disadvantages of a credit card. Those are, I guess, all of the main options to buy a restomod and the pros and cons of each. To summarize it all, I highly recommend doing a home equity line of credit if you are a homeowner and you qualify. If not, I would say spend the time to do some math between a specialized dealership like Woodside Credit is who I like. There's a couple, and your private banker. But either way, I would say you can definitely understand your options better and make an informed decision when you think through the whole thing. Now, here are some extra credit tips if you stuck around this long that people don't really think about when it comes to financing a restomod. But the true cost to own a restomod is more than just the purchase price, right? There's storage. Are you gonna store this? Is it gonna be heated storage? Is it gonna be, you know, enclosed? Insurance. Have you thought about insurance? And by the way, an insurance consideration will be, of course, the price of the vehicle, but also the replacement price. And be careful of this, because a lot of traditional insurance companies don't understand investment grade restomods. And so the price they quote you for insurance is not a guaranteed replacement price. It's the price it's valued at, which may be a very different price than you've actually paid. I have a video coming up on this. Don't get too hung up on this in this conversation. This is really how to get a Restomod loan without getting ripped off. That's the goal of this. But again, the extra credit components are, there are a couple other things that factor into the cost of owning a Restomod that you may or may not be thinking about. Modifications, when people buy a Restomod, it's not unusual to want to go put money into them. In other words, you may buy a Restomod, but it isn't the right color. So maybe you want to finance the cost of a paint job into it. So if there's any Restomod modifications you want to make, you may want to think about that as a part of your loan process as well. And those classic car company finance companies are able to handle that. They get that. They understand it. It's not foreign to them. It'll be much more foreign to your bank, your local bank, than it will be to those people. Are you going to take it to car shows? And if you're going to take it to car shows, do you need to buy a trailer to haul it back and forth, or can you drive it back and forth? Who will maintain it? Will someone locally maintain it? I live up north in northern Michigan, and I actually drive about 3 hours away to get my car maintained by a company who specializes in classic cars. So, as you can tell, there is more to the story than just buying it. There's the cost of ownership as well. However, when it comes to Restomod financing, I hope that you found this video helpful. I'm hoping that you learned a couple things, or maybe there's a couple things you hadn't thought about when it comes to financing your Restomod. Either way, if you liked the video, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell so you get alerted when I have a new video. I have at least one, if not two, videos come out every week. And again, these videos' sole purpose are to help you in your pursuit and your passion of Restomods, just like my passion is Restomods. And we're going to have tips and tricks and videos and how-to guides and videos just like this one that help simplify the process of owning or acquiring a Restomod. So thanks again for tuning in, and enjoy your Restomod.